Soumya, take attendance. After.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I can't see you.
Yeah, I have stopped the video. Just let me take attendance after that. Okay,
ma'am.
Only very few have entered. Now, can you see me, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, listen. Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Echo is coming.
Echo is coming. Yes, ma'am. Okay, children, now.
Still, ma'am, echo is coming.
Ma'am,
I can, yeah. Hello? I can hear my voice is echo.
Okay, okay. Okay, check whether my voice is echoing. Okay, children, so do you remember? Echo is. Echo is coming.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Second time your voice is coming repeating. It's there after some time. So children, let's start with the class. Everybody have joined. 26 participants are there. Okay. No. Okay, how are you all?
Fine, ma'am.
Okay. So do you remember what all things we studied last class? Huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Where did we stop?
Adjacent angles.
You have studied supplementary angles, complementary angles,
adjacent angles.
Isn't it? Yeah. You have studied adjacent angles, right? Hello?
Yes.
Adjacent angles. Okay, Noor. You were there last class. Hello? Noor Al Haya.
Yes, ma'am.
Am I audible to you?
Yes.
Okay. You were there in the last class, no?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, I was there.
There was there. No videos. Okay. Yes, Hashir Salil, just click on your video. Many videos are off. Shahan Nazar, Agash P. Unnikrishnan. Video, switch on your video. Many have switched off video and gone for tea. Where are you? FNs. Emmanuel. Yeah, Hashir Salil. Don't hide. Emmanuel, Effins and Emmanuel, switch on your video. Okay, you cannot go for coffee or tea now. Huh? Switch on your video. I want to see all of your faces. Anybody else is there? All have switched on the video. Okay. Yes. Okay, tell me. Noor Al Haya, tell me. What did you understand from adjacent angles? Adjacent angles.
They have a common vertex.
Okay, they have a common vertex.
They have a common arm.
Common arm.
The non-common arm are on either of the common.
Okay, arm. Very good, very good. And all the exercises also we have done. Now next topic is linear pair. Linear pair. So adjacent angles you understood. Now we have linear pair. What do you understand from linear pair? Did I explain that? Linear pair. Okay, I'll ask to Nakul PS. Nakul? Hello? Nakul, are you hearing me? No. No response. Nakul, you switched off your video. Nakul. Switched off your video. When asking question, you have switched off your video. Why? Okay. Yes, Gobiga. Gobiga, tell me. What is a linear pair?
Which Gobiga?
Hello.
Which Gobiga?
Be Lola asleep. Shreya. Okay. Adilakshmi.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Hi, ma'am.
Am I audible? Adilakshmi.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What is a linear pair?
It's a line. Linear.
Not clear. I'll explain. Okay. Now we shall... explain once more what is a linear pair. Okay. After that, we'll go for some problems related to it. No. Screen. Share. Okay, so you can see the screen, no, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, now let me draw. You know what are adjacent angles, isn't it? You know what are adjacent angles. Now, this is also a pair of adjacent angles. O. This ray, let it be OC, OB, and OA. This is an angle, this is another angle. Okay. Now, color it. Look here. What about these angles? These are adjacent angles because they have a common vertex. They have a common vertex O. And they have a common ray, that is ray OA, isn't it? They have a common ray, ray OA. And they have a common vertex O. And they have two non-common arms. See this, two non-common arms. On either side of the common arm. So, do they form an pair of adjacent angle, children? Do they form a pair of adjacent angle?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes ma'am. They form a pair of adjacent angle. But some peculiarities are there than normal adjacent angle. What is it? You can see these two rays, that is non-common arms, these two non-common arms form a straight line, isn't it? The two non-common arms form a straight line. This is the common arm. These two are called the non-common arms. They are forming a straight line, or they form together 180 degree, isn't it? Hello? Are you listening? Are you listening?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So the other two rays or arms form 180 degree or a straight line. Such pair of adjacent angles are known as linear pair. Linear pair.
Linear equation, one variable.
Not linear equation, that is another thing. This is linear pair. Linear pair. See this. This together forms a semicircular angle. That is 180 degree. Okay. You do not see the angle. This can be any degree. But this both together will form 180 degree. Such pair of adjacent angles are known as linear pair. Okay. Now understood linear pair. Now one more thing is, we'll do two problems related to it. After that, we'll go for the next term. So the definition of linear pair goes like this. Pair of adjacent angles whose non-common arms are opposite rays pair of adjacent angles whose non-common arms are opposite rays are known as is known as a linear pair. Linear pair. Pair one. Okay. So pair of adjacent angles whose non-common arms are opposite rays. You can see, the both non-common arms were just opposite to each other. Such pair of angles are known as linear pair. And the angles form a straight line. Okay. That is 180 degree. So such a pair of angles are known as linear pair. You should keep a rough note and a pen with you. Pencil and also a scale. Okay. Now I'll give you another one problem. Just try to solve it, then you will understand. Now just see this. This is a line. Another line. This angle is 50 degree. Okay. Find x. What is the answer? You can do all these problems in your rough book. Okay. What is the other angle? It's a linear pair. No, by just watch it, watch the figure, you can find out that it's a linear pair because opposite rays form a straight line. Okay, so tell me, opposite rays form a straight line, they are linear pair. So what is x? One angle is given, find the other angle.
130 degrees.
Who answered? Who have answered? Oh, Govinda. Okay. Who have answered?
130 degree.
Okay. Yes. Answer is?
130 degree.
Why 130 degree?
X minus 50. I mean 180 minus 50.
Very good. So total, this together forms 180 degree. So X plus 50 is equal to 180 degree. So what is X? X is equal to 180 minus 50. Answer is 130 degree. Is it clear, children? Write down this. I'll give you another problem. One more problem. Okay, fine. Is it? Next angle. I'll call you. Okay, next one is just. Who is this? Shahaban. Shahaban, answer this question. What is Z angle? What is Z angle? Angle Z. What is angle Z? Yes, tell me. You are not listening. What is angle Z?
Can I tell the answer?
Wait, wait. He was not listening. I can see you from here. Shahaban. No answer. Okay. Just hear what others say and you should answer me. Once more, I'll ask you. Okay, Gopika Shankar, you can answer.
And it's 120 degree.
120 degree. Good. Why you answered like that?
Because x is equals to 180 minus 60.
Good. Both so, angles together form 180 degree because it is a linear pair. So Z plus 60 is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, we can say that Z is equal to 180 minus 60 degree. Okay. Yes, Shahaban, can you answer now? Shahaban. Tell me. What is the answer? Loudly. I can't hear you.
180.
180. What is the value of X? Z. What is the value of Z? What is the value of Z? What is the total value? X, Z plus 60, what is the answer? What is Z plus 60? Okay, Agash, turn on your video. Agash, no video is seen. Agash.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Agash, what is the answer? What is Z plus 60?
Ma'am, I will do and say 120 degree. 120 degree.
What is Z plus 60?
110.
Are you sleeping?
No, ma'am.
Then?
Wait, I will do and say.
What is Z plus 60? What is the answer? Renon. Renon.
180.
Excuse me. Loudly.
180.
180. Good. So answer is 180. Z plus 60, you will get 180. So what is Z? Z is equal to 180 minus 60. What is the answer? Z is equal to 120 degree. So is it clear, children? Linear pair.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, linear pair. Those who have were listening can understand. Okay. Some are sleeping. Those people who are sleeping cannot understand. Emmanuel, I want to see your face. Put on the lights. You're sitting in darkness. Come out. Turn on your video. Okay. Now listen. So hope you all understood linear pair. Now we shall pass on to the next topic. That is, because your class is a little bit late. The other sections have finished all this topics. Now, just see. We are going to study what are vertically opposite words. Okay, now see this figure. You can draw two lines. Draw in your rough book. Draw in your rough book one line L, other line M. Line M and line L. Okay, now you just measure this angle and this angle. Measure it with your protractor. Okay, draw two lines like this on the board and just simply with pencil and scale. Okay, and after that you just measure the opposite angles. Measure with protractor. Measure with protractor. Did you all measure with protractor, children? Do you know? I hope you know to measure with protractor. Last year I have taught you. Okay. Karthik Vinod, you are not doing anything? Yes, Anna Binu. Anna.
Yes, ma'am.
Did you measure?
Yes, ma'am.
What did you understand? What did you understand?
Ma'am, we are measuring vertical opposite angles.
With protractor, you have to measure. Okay. Did you notice any peculiarity?
Ma'am, everything is
yes.
Same degrees.
Same degree. Okay, very good, very good, very good. And others also, try yourself. You can see that. What about anybody else? Anybody else have got the same answer? Just click on an answer.
Yes, ma'am. I got the same answer.
Who is answering?
Ma'am Ashwin.
Okay. So, if you measure properly with protractor, you can understand that the opposite angles formed are equal in measure. Okay. When you measure it properly, you can understand that the opposite angles formed. You see on the board, the opposite angles formed are equal in measure. Sorry, the color is changing. I will just color it down. Thank you. Now, look here. This is an opposite angle. These two are opposite angles. Do it again. Like this. Angle X is opposite to. Let us see this angle B. I can say that this angle X is opposite to P, vertically opposite to P. Or we'll take angle 1, 2, 3. Angle 1, 2, 3, 4 we can take. We'll take angle 1, 2, 3, 4. Instead of X, Y, Z, we can take angle 1, 2, 3, 4. Let this be angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. Now, what did you observe? What did you understand? Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. 4 is equal to angle 2. Did you get it? Then, when you measure, you will get like that. The opposite angles are always equal. And we call them as vertically opposite angles. Okay, angle 1 is equal to angle 3 and see, angle 1 is equal to angle 3, angle 4 is equal to angle 2. These are called the vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. And this vertically opposite angles are equal in measure. This is the rule which we are learning today. Okay, now we'll pass on to, so is it clear, children? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
When two lines intersect, when I'll put a rubber band on it and I'll show you what is it. I have taken two pencil. Consider this as two lines. Okay. I have just put a rubber band. You can see daily life examples like this. No? Can you see this type of example from your daily life, intersecting lines? Forming vertically opposite angles. Can you tell me an example from your daily life?
Scissors.
Anybody?
Scissors.
From your daily life. Example of vertically opposite angles. Have you seen scissors? Scissors.
Yes.
I know answer. Gauri Priya. Yes, Gauri Priya. Can you give me an example from the nature, from your surroundings for this vertically opposite angles?
Same question. I can't hear you.
Louder. I can't hear you. You are saying something, but I can't hear.
I can't hear you properly.
Louder.
Ma'am, I can't hear you.
Okay. You're not audible to me. Sneha Sawani? Sneha?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What? Give an example from your surroundings for vertically opposite angles. Not audible. Nihan Salim, just now I said.
No answer.
Hello. No answer. Yes.
Sister.
Okay. Just pass on to. Yes, Donald. Donald Joseph, turn on your video. Yes, switch off the video. Turn on your video, tell me. Can you give an example from your surroundings for vertically opposite angles? Donal. Means you people are not listening. Yes, I'll pass to next one. Karthik Vinod.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes, tell me an example from your from the surroundings for vertically opposite angles.
Ma'am, I don't know.
Ma'am, can I say?
Yes. Who is it?
Chahan.
Chahan, okay, okay. Tell me. Hello?
This is us.
This is us, okay. That I said, but nobody has listened to it. Okay. Now next, you see this pencil, just I have crossed it. Just I have put a rubber band over it. Am I getting a vertically opposite angles? You can see?
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't it? How many angles are formed? How many angles are formed?
Four
angles, isn't it? Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. In this, we can say that top and bottom are vertically opposite angles. Left and right are other pair of opposite, vertically opposite angles. So how many pair of vertically opposite angles you found? How many pair of vertically opposite angles you found?
Two
pairs, isn't it? Okay, so two lines, when two lines meet together or intersect, two pairs of vertically opposite angles are obtained, and these two pairs of vertically opposite angles are equal in measure. Okay, this is what we learned in this topic. Now, we'll go. Hope you all have understood. Anybody have switched off their video? Switch on their video. Okay. Noor, what happened? Noor, what happened? You have switched off your video. All the videos should be on. Microphones can be switched off. If I ask you to... Yes, go Biga. Okay, now another screen I'll show you. So far whatever we have studied, we can see it is Can you see the screen, children? Hello? Mm-hmm. Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, I can't see the screen.
Ma'am, I can't see the screen.
You cannot see the screen. Okay.
Ma'am, I can't see the screen.
Okay. We'll go back. Wait a minute. So adjacent angles, this we have seen, no? What are adjacent angles? They have a common vertex. They have a common arm. Non-common arms are on either side of the common arm. Next one. Okay.
Ma'am, this one I cannot see the screen.
Can you see the board, children? First
yes,
one.
Ma'am.
First one is a linear. Sorry. What is the question? Adjacent angle. First one. Are there a pair of adjacent angles?
Ma'am.
Yes. Second one?
Ma'am, I cannot see the
screen. Cannot see the screen. What about others?
Yes, ma'am.
Can see.
You can see, no?
No.
Hello? Ma'am, I can't see.
Hello, can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, second one. First one, is it forming a pair of adjacent angles?
Yes.
Yes. Second one. Second one, are they forming a pair of adjacent angles?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then third one.
No.
No. Why? Because?
They don't have
A?
Common.
Hello. Loudly.
They don't have a common vertex.
Good. They don't have a common vertex, isn't it? Now, we'll pass on to the next. Now, see, what is a linear pair? What is a linear pair? Linear pair is a pair of adjacent angles whose non-common sides are opposite rays. See, in this case, first case, this case, they form a linear pair, isn't it? They form a linear pair. First case, the opposite rays form a linear pair. Sorry, opposite rays form 180 degree. So, we can say that this is a linear pair. What about the other one? Does it form?
No, ma'am. No.
Sub 180 degree?
No, ma'am.
No. So, that is not a pair of, that is not, that adjacent and pair of adjacent angles are not a linear pair.
Okay.
So, understood what is a linear pair? Always
yes,
the opposite rays form 180 degree or a straight line. Then only we can say that is a linear pair. Okay. Next one. Now, from real life, you can take examples of linear pair. See this? See this figures? Look. A vegetable chopping board. So, you can see here, this is one angle, and see this 180 degree. It is forming a semicircular angle, isn't it? That means it is forming 180 degree. It's an example of linear pair. Next one, you see pen stand. Pen stand also, see the base, a straight line. And another one is going, another ray is going. And here, the two angles form 180 degree total. Isn't it?
Linear pair.
So we can say that is also a pair of, forming a pair of linear. Those pairs of adjacent angles form linear. Next one. So, can two acute angles form a linear pair? Think.
No.
Can two acute angles form linear pair?
No.
Tell me.
No, ma'am.
No.
Loudly.
No, ma'am.
Because? Why?
They don't form 180 degree.
Say loudly. Whoever is answer. Anybody can answer.
Ma'am, they don't form 180 degree.
They are less than 90 degrees, isn't it? Both will be less than 90 degree. So, total, we won't get 180 degree. So, the answer is no. Two acute angles cannot form a linear pair. Then second one. Can two obtuse angles form a linear pair?
No, ma'am.
Obtuse angles, can they form a linear pair?
No, ma'am.
Because both are more than 90 degree. So when you add, it will be more than 180, isn't it? So they also cannot form a linear pair. Third question, can two right angles form a linear pair?
Yes, ma'am.
Because each one is 90 degree. So 90 plus 90 can form 180.
Okay.
Next question. Then next one. Okay. That slide is over. Next slide.
card in my
card no
I have a left side to cut over in
all the tone
Can you see the screen children No
No ma'am.
No ma'am.
No ma'am. Okay.
No ma'am.
Okay. I'll go to desktop. Now just I want to close it. Can you see board, children? No.
No, ma'am.
Okay. 4:30. Now. Yeah, yeah.
1:40.
Now, can you see children? Board.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Now. We'll go to another slide. So what did we learn about vertically opposite angles? When opposite angles are vertically opposite angles are equal in measure. When two lines intersect, the vertically angles for vertically opposite angles so formed are equal. Now see this figure. See this figure. Two lines L and M are crossing each other or meeting each other. Isn't it? See, this is line L and this is line M. They meet together at a point called O. Now, angle 4 is a vertically opposite angle to angle 2. And angle 1 is vertically opposite to angle 3. Okay. So, angle 4 is equal to angle 2. And angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Right? So we say that opposite angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. When two lines intersect, vertically opposite angles are always equal. Now we shall pass on to some problems. Hope it is clear to you. The slide is this. Next one. It's an example from real life which I have shown you. Can you see the board, children? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Two pencils tied together. Next figure, no, the same thing. Now we shall remove it. I will give you a problem based on this. Okay. Look. Very easy topic. Now, this angle, angle Z is equal to 110 degrees. Find Z. Z is not there, you can draw. See this, 110, this angle is 110 and you have to find out what is x, what is y, what is z. Okay, so just try out. What is x, children? What is the value of x? Angle x will be? Can you tell me the measure of angle X?
110.
110. Who answered?
Gopika.
Gautam.
Gopika.
Hello?
Ma'am, Gopika.
Gopika, okay, okay. 110. Why did you say 110?
Because the opposite.
They form vertically opposite angles. Good. So X is equal to 110 degree because they are vertically opposite. You have to write the reason also. Vertically opposite. Vertically opposite. Now, what is measure of angle Z? What is the measure of angle Z? Yes. Can you tell?
And is it 70 degree?
Excuse me, loudly.
70 degree.
70 degree. Who is answering?
Ma'am, Gopika Shankar.
Gopika Shankar, very good. So answer is 70 degree. Why you said 70 degree?
Ma'am, because the rest two angles, when we add them, we'll get 220 degree. Mm. And a full circle is 360 degree.
Okay, that is correct. Before that, we can say that this line, just check this line. It's forming a straight line, no? See, this angle is 180 degree, right? Hmm? So your answer is correct because total 360 degree, then we will get. Now, here, just check this line. This line you check, it is forming a linear pair, isn't it? So we can say 110 plus Z. 110 plus 110 plus Z is equal to 180 degree. Now, what is Z? 180 minus 110. That is equal to 70 degree, isn't it? So we got 70 here. Then it is easy to find out the other one now. It's 110. Now what is Z, children? Z? Sorry, Y. What is Y?
70 degree.
It is 70 degree. Y is equal to 70 degree. Because the Z is equal to Y. 70 degree. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Clear? Then one more problem. You have to write down this problem in your rough book and you have to write in your note neatly. Now you can take down in your rough book. Okay. One more problem related to this. Same type question, others can also answer. Robert scale. The point is O. Now, we have find out the angles, other angles. Find out other angles. Do it. All of you should do. Nobody can sit idle here. All of you should do the problem. I'll be asking the question. Now I have explained, isn't it?
I got the answer.
Yes, who got the answer?
Me, Gopika Shankar.
Okay, Gopika, you have answered one question, no? Okay? Okay, I'll ask you. Okay, after, let me see whether others are getting the answer. Anybody else other than Gopika Shankar? Good, Gopika Shankar, you got the answer. I'll ask you, I'll come back to you. Okay, let me see whether anybody else have got the answer. Emmanuel, what are you doing? Did you get the answer? No answering?
Am I doing the arm?
Yes. Unmute your audio. Unmute your audio. Nihan, unmute your audio. Then only you can speak to me. Speaker button. Press the speaker button. Okay, Nagul PS. Nagul. Nakul is not there. No video. Yes, Rinon. Good. Rinon, tell me, what is the answer?
150.
Very good, very good. 150. Okay. So we got 150 degrees.
Yeah.
X is equal to X is equal to 150.
Did it?
How did you get it? Tell me, explain. How did you get it?
Rinon. By 180 minus 30.
Good. 180 minus 30. So X is equal to 150 because X plus 30 is equal to 180 because it forms a linear pair here. See the straight line. Okay, so it forms a straight line over there and it forms a linear pair. So we can say X plus 30 is equal to 180. So X is equal to 180 minus 30. Okay, that is answer is 150 degrees. Okay, now tell me what is who got the answer? Gopika Shankar, you can tell me what is the answer. Is that
150 degree?
That is also 150 degree because they are vertically opposite angles, isn't it? We can say X is equal to Z. Recent vertically opposite angles. Recent should be there when you write the answer. Vertically opposite angles. Next one. See, next one, what is next? X is equal to Z, you got. Now, Y. 30. What is Y, children?
30 degree.
Because vertically opposite angles are equal. So, Y is equal to what? Y is equal
30
to 30 degree.
Degree.
Okay, Y is equal to 30 degree. This is one of the problem. Now, next, same type. Another problem you have to do. It's of same type, little more. You have to think and answer such a type of question. Okay, so let us do that problem also. After that, this topic will be over, and I'll give you the homework related. Hope you all have copied the problem. No, you have to do it yourself. Okay, children.
Bye.
No sound from the. See, some noises are coming from somebody's house. Please mute your audio. If any small children are there nearby, please mute your audio. Otherwise, it will be a disturbance for the class. Next question. Next one. All of you draw this figure, okay? You have to take down the question. Yeah. Now we'll try to answer this. What is X? Try to do it. Do it, all of you. Then I'll give you some time. Find out the answers. Find X, what is, find Y, and find Z. Do it. You can do. Whoever is getting the answer first, you can answer. Okay.
I got the answer.
Yes. Yes. Who is answering, children? Who is speaking to me?
Gopika C. Kumar.
Gopika. Yes, Gopika. Tell me the answer. Your audio, your video is switched off. Gopika RM it is. Okay. Gopika RM, switch on your video. FNs. I can see. Huh? FNs also. Switch on your video. I can see everybody from here. You have switched off and went somewhere? Wazim. Yes. No video. Okay, Gopika, answer me. What is X? What is X you got?
Ma'am, 155 degree.
155
degree.
55. Loudly.
45.
Excuse me. What is X? Value of X? 100. Gopika. Hello. What is X? Value of X?
Ma'am, 130.
No. No. See, this is forming a straight line.
Okay. 115.
That is the correct answer. I'll tell you how. See, you see, this is forming a straight line, no? So together it will be 180 degree, isn't it? It's forming a straight line. So together, what is together? 40 plus X plus 25. So we say 40 plus X plus 25 is equal to 180 degree, isn't it? Now, 40 plus X plus 25 is equal to 180 degree. So 40 plus 25 is 65. Plus X is equal to 180. Now, X is equal to 180 minus 65. So, we will get 115 degree. Okay. X is equal to 115 degree. Now, you got X as 115 degree. Now, what about Z? Sneha Soni, answer me. What about Z? Z?
Ma'am, I can't hear you.
You can't hear me. What is the value of angle Z?
I can say.
Yes, who is that? Sony, answer me. Sneha. One minute. Sneha, can you answer me? Sneha, can you answer me?
I'm sorry, but I can't hear you.
I can hear you. You say, I'll get the answer. Z, what is the value of Z? What is the value of Z? Now, can you hear me? Huh?
I'm sorry.
No. You don't know. Okay, who said?
I can say.
Yes, who is it?
Renon.
Renon. Okay, good. Renon, tell me the answer.
40.
40. Why? Why you said that answer? Z is equal to 40. Why?
Because 40 and Z is opposite.
Very good, very good. So 40 and this 40 degree and this Z, you can see they form a pair of vertically opposite angles, isn't it? So Z is equal to 40 degree. Okay. So Z is equal to 40 degree. Now, next one, Y. What is Y? Let me check whether I can put it forward, upward, bench. So what was the figure? Let me draw again. This was the figure. And this figure, rough figure I'm drawing. It was 25 degree. This was x, and this was 40 degree. 40 degree. Now we have y is there, z is there. Now I told x plus 40 plus 25 is equal to 180 degrees. Now x plus 65 is equal to 180 degrees. So x is equal to 180 minus 65, that we get 115 degrees. Now what was then we told what is z? Z is equal to 40 degrees because vertically opposite to this angle 40 degree. Okay, then next, what is y?
Can I say the answer?
Yes. Who is it? Gopika Shankar again?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Anybody else? No. Tell me the answer.
Ma'am, it's 140 degree.
140 degree. Why did you say 140 degree?
Ma'am, because 40 degree plus y is 180 degree.
Okay, very good, very good. So 40 degree plus y is equal to 180 degree, isn't it? Because this is a straight line. See, this is forming a straight line. So this angle is 180 degree, right? That is forming 180 degree. So what? 40 plus y is equal to 180 degree. So what is y? Y is equal to 180 minus 40. That we get 140 degree. Clear, children? So like that, we got x 115 degree, z 40 degree, and this one 140 degree. Okay. You want me to explain again? Children, what about this? Baja?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Did you understand?
No, ma'am.
Why?
Ma'am, there was power failure.
Okay. So you didn't understand. So you were not there from the beginning?
No, ma'am. I was there in between the power failure.
So you understood what are vertically opposite angles and all, no?
Yes.
Yes. Only this problem. In the beginning, you didn't understand.
Yeah.
Where is the doubt? Ask me.
Ma'am, this question.
Yes?
This question.
Now, this question, where did you, didn't understand? Where is the doubt?
Why?
Why? Why is here, this you understood, x how 115 came? X is equal to 115?
Yes.
Yes, because this forms a straight line, isn't it? So you see here, it is total 180. That is why we told 40 plus x plus 25. 40 plus x plus 25 is equal to 180. Why? This forms a straight line. Okay. Did you understand? Baja?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now the same way, you check here, this 40 degree and z, are they forming vertically opposite angles?
Yes.
Yes. That is why we got z 40 degree.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Now, your doubt is this 140 degree, isn't it?
Yes.
That is, you just same line you check under also, it is forming 180
degree.
Bottom. Isn't it? Y plus z. What is y plus z? Look here. I'll tell. Look here. Our figure was this. This was like this. Like this. And this was 25 degree. This was x. And this was 40 degree. Now, this is y. This is z. Now, 40 plus x plus 24. See, it is forming a straight line. So, we can say, here also 180 degrees form. So, I write 40 plus x plus 25 is equal to 180, and we got x is equal to 180 minus 65. We got x is equal to 115 degrees. Yes, 115 degrees. Now, 14, this angle and this angle forms vertically opposite angle. So, z is equal to 40 degrees. We got. Now, next is this. This line you check bottom here also it is making 180 degrees, isn't it?
Yes.
So, y plus z is equal to 180. So, what is z? We got 40 degrees. Z is 40 degrees, vertically opposite. So, we can say y plus 40 is equal to 180. So, what is y? Y is equal to 180 minus 40.
Minus 40.
Answer is
140 degrees.
Okay, clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So, hope all of you have understood the concept of vertically opposite angles, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What about others? Okay. Now, Agash, where were you? You are not seen till now. Only now I can see your face.
I am here. I am here.
For P, I think, in between. Or... Okay, did you understand?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So, I'll be giving homework based on this today. Not only this, okay, Sunday you have to sit and do the homework. Monday also is there. Tuesday only in the next class will be there. So, just sit and study the notes and all you have to write. These problems, whatever we wrote, you have taken down in your rough book. You have to write in the note.
And
hello, switch off your speakers, children.
Ma'am, finish.
Switch off your speaker. Okay, so now listen. You will have to write this in note. I'll be giving the homework today. Do it. Okay, so come. We'll stop sharing. Hi, children. So, I hope this Hashir Salil.
Bye.
Where you went? Are you here? Hashir?
Yes.
Any other noises coming, please switch off your audio. Okay. Effins, just switch on your audio. Speak to me. How are you?
Fine.
Fine. Okay. Thank you. You didn't answer the questions. Okay. Next time, I'll ask you. You should be ready. Clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now, Agash.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you ready? You were there in the last class, right? Did you all understand?
Yes.
Did you understand all the topics? Very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I can see only very few students over here. Just let me click on. Okay, fine. So, hope you all have understood, children. So, bye.
Yes, ma'am.
It's time to wind up the class. I'll give you the homework and the notes. Okay, so write down whatever you have taken down in the rough book. Write as your note and also the homework I'll give you. Okay, thank you. Bye, children.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.